Hey guys, I'm Xinyuan. I'm sitting here to speak a few words which I find quite important. The few words about the program I'm going to present in a few days. So it's all about Mozart, Kurtág, Mendelssohn, and finally Schumann. I chose this program, I pick up those pieces because I do have a kind of thoughts behind it. There are four, I want to present four different emotions with each piece. So, because emotion-wise, style-wise, but also structure-wise, they're all very different. In Mozart, it's probably the most typical, this sonata could represent the most typical style of Mozart. It's elegant, it's innocent, it's happy, it's so pure. And beyond that, this sonata, E flat major, I'm going to play, is probably the only sonata which starts with a slow movement. Probably my most beloved slow movement is aria. This theme give me such a feeling. It's just like it shows how lovely this character is, and how it means that composer would like to show his love to the world, to the people he loved, with the little bit child, this innocence, something like that. The beginning sounds like that. Slight hesitation, but they're all kind of, for me, it's like a child with innocence, with wonder, with curiosity, and then it follows with this. Then suddenly he opens himself. See, just the notes are quite few, not so many, it's not Rachmaninoff, but you can see the information is so clear and we can understand immediately. I think you would do as well. And this is Mozart, and then it turns to we go to Mendelssohn, which the atmosphere changed immediately to be the different atmosphere, which is, it's a very serious, because not just because the title is variation series, but also not only emotional wise but also structure wise you can see this is a variation where I find it's probably this structure wise most perfectly piece, one of I've ever played. It sounds beginning like this. Thank you. this theme, it always makes me associate with the other example, and that is the Chaconne by Bach, transcribed by Busoni. I find this the atmosphere is very much dissimilar. Of course, there are quite a few differences. I want to show you. This is a Busoni. Never played. Haven't played yet. Declamation. It's kind of very extroverted, and this Mendelssohn, this one, is very introverted. You just don't play for himself. But the common point between these two is they're all very serious. Also, they're in the same key, D minor. And one of this feature I found is Mendelssohn's variation is also the structure is so just the order following this following the variation. Whatever they changed, technically the notes, the different variations, they never leave from the very origin this structure of the thing. So let me make an example. This second variation. And in this variation, the major part, the second part, I want to show you that he actually still put the main notes from the thing in the variation. Follows the structure of the theme in every variations. Also, in some very ferocious parts, just like you. You can see. Same shape, this shape of the phrase. And then there's a major part which I find is quite special. In particular, it has a special connection with the Chaconne I'm going to present. Sounds like this in Mendelssohn. Just like one plays the organ in a church. And the same thing has happened also in the chakong, the major part. Sense of religious, so it's like a ritual.
Yep.
Now about the Kurtág, well, firstly, I'm very honored that my teacher, Balaj Sokolai, he is exactly the pupil of George Kurtág, and well, I personally never met Kurtág, but my professor explained to me lots of the stories about Kurtág, and I actually, when every time I play his music, I feel so close psychologically. I mean, I can feel immediately what he was going to say every piece. And about these games, Hungarian word is játékok. The games, it's a kind of musically very abstract piece, which every piece is very short. Some piece is just a few notes, but very amazingly that Kurtág could actually draw a picture and present to us through these few tones. I named just one example. It's one of his piece is called Flowers Frail. It's only seven tones. I mean, but the process for me, so it's like an image of an open dish of flowers through the seven tones, gradually and slowly close itself, and finally eventually vanish. So something like that. Actually, a particular one, which is my favorite Kurtág, is this piece, which kind of it's sounds just like a reminiscence of one's past. This reminiscence is very unclear. It sounds just like an impressionism. I would want to play this film. Thank you. sounds like a melody, but it's not a regular melody. It's just an impression. It's just through this the pedal throughout the one pedal throughout the whole piece. You can see this. It's just like the impressionist was this kind of painting, something like that. So now about the Schumann, and this is probably the craziest piece I've ever known in Schumann's music. And I chose this F sharp minor sonata because I feel I love this sonata so much that I can clearly see this typical contrast between the Florenstein and the Eusebius, these two figures, fantasy figures, they're never real, but this it's like conflict, it's contrast. So I think the Florenstein is very wild, it's manlike. Full of tenderness, very soft, and lovingness as well. It's not only happen between the inner movement, but also the figure, these two figures can switch between the movements as well. What does that mean? So, well, the first movement, I think, is majorly just represents Florenstein, which is Schumann himself. We know that these two figures, they are all originally created by Schumann himself, and I think Florenstein means Schumann himself, which is kind of full of anxiety, full of passion, this kind of character. And another part is exactly his wife, Clara Schumann, which is exactly the kind of opposite this case. Well, and besides, this piece was dedicated to Clara Schumann, so it means something. And I personally want to find the first movement is simply just represents this Schumann's own character, Robert Schumann's own character, just like this. German words is called Aufschwung. So, in the contrast, the second movement is totally different. It's just, I think it's just the female voice. It's a voice of love, like a proposal. in this melody that you will feel that there's going to be something dramatically happened afterward. No, you just simply, you are just simply in this pure, this very like a paradise. Yeah. And suddenly, after the ending of this piece, drama. And one of the things I like Schumann the most is that he always creates another this kind of character without any hint, without any, let's say, a crescendo or something like this, a process. Just a typical example, just what I just play. Without any crescendo, same thing as here as well. Without any prophecy. Yeah. So, in general, these are the music world I want to present to you in a few days. They are just like its own world. And I hope you're gonna like it. And in a word, I mean, these are kind of my beloved program, and I think you could enjoy it. Thank you.